Hello and welcome to this video. This is Modify Crypto and I am Mo. So today I want to take us through basically my favorite projects on the Phantom network. I'm going to advise you from the start today to do your own research. This is not financial advice, and the longer you spend in the crypto space, you'll realize that everyone is shilling their own projects that they like, and you can't just trust anyone on the internet that says something is good. You got to do your own research and build your own conviction. So I'm here just to show you, educate you, and give you some options, but you need to go away and do the work and find out if it's for you. So the first one I like is Spirit Swap, which is an exchange. So what happens when you connect to your phone's internet, it's not super fast. You've got a normal exchange here, and what's nice, it gives you a little chart as well when it wants to work, and we can swap like loads of tokens, really, just like a normal DEX, which is cool. And you can also zap your tokens, which means you can take like one token and it will automatically split it into the two tokens you need to provide liquidity. So that can be an easy way just to provide liquidity rather than having to say take half that amount and then buy another token and then provide both tokens as liquidity. Here you can just use the one. It doesn't want to work for me right now, but it's pretty simple. They also have a nice bridge, and for me, this is how I got a lot of my funds onto Phantom. For me, I actually went from Avalanche here, and you can move things over like this as well. I'm pretty sure I moved over MIM, actually. Yeah, I did, but you know what? To do that, I went to Abracadabra to move over my funds, which is quite cheap. So it's a bridge. We have our farms here. We should all know what farms are. I think I'm in the S spell farm because I want the exposure to farm. The real thing here is the InSpirit token here. So this is where you can lock away your spirit tokens, and then you earn protocol fees. So the this model copies the Curve model here, and we all know how hot Curve is right now. So I've done an unlock tokens away. I'm earning a reward every week. I get to vote on which pools get extra awards. These are the boosted farms. I'm currently in the ETH Phantom farm, so I tend to vote every week to boost up this. This is really good. I would check out Spirit and InSpirit. This is my like number one place to go to swap or to do things here. We've got Lend and Borrow as well, but I'm not so interested in that at the moment. Bonds, I don't mess around with bonds. I don't fully understand it yet, and as I've said to you, if you don't fully understand something, you shouldn't like just jump into it because people have told you. So I've stayed away from bonds. WinSpirit, which is wrapped in Spirit, and this is other protocols that are buying up the Spirit token so they can control where the rewards are going to. So here, this LinSpirit is Liquid Driver, which is another protocol, and here is JinSpirit, which is Grim Finance. So as you can see here, I believe Grim has just been hacked or exploited, so I'm going to stay away from this, and luckily I never got into this. However, I am currently in the LinSpirit ecosystem, so that's Liquid Driver, and so I'm going to take over here now and show you liquid driver. So basically with this, they are buying up the liquid token and staking it on your behalf, and then with that they're earning the protocol fees as if you held the InSpirit token, but also, and then they are able to boost certain farms and get rewards that way. So just let me show you that. If I go to XLiquider, so when you receive your liquid tokens as reward for farming, you can lock your liquid tokens away. I've already locked some away, and you can do that for 2 years, which I've done. And here is until when it's locked, until 2023. So once I've locked away my liquid driver LQDR, I'm gonna receive X liquid, and then by holding X liquid, I am going to get exposure to this over here. So as you can see, I'm going to receive 27% in LQDR, that 7.7% in Phantom, 39% in Boo, 83.5% in Lin Spirit. Remember, that's the like locked like spirit tokens. It's a liquid version, which is pretty good. And also 3% in spell tokens. So that's a nice way, and that's totaling 160% odd. This was about 200 maybe a week or two ago, so it is coming down, but that's still a healthy amount to be earning. And look at the diversity of what you're getting. You could choose to stake these to lock them, or you could sell them. I mean, Lin Spirit generates you money, Boo can generate you money, Liquid Driver generates you money, Spell, when you lock that, can generate you money, and the Phantom is like, you know, the gas token of the Phantom network. So I mean, that could be good to have if you're bullish on the ecosystem. Yeah, so this is a way to generate more funds. So if anyone is familiar with the, is this gonna work, let's try. If I go on Ethereum, it's similar to Convex and the Curve relationship here. So Convex is, well, let's do it first. Curve, which is the DEX where you can swap coins. I don't want to change my wallet. Curve is similar to InSpirit or Spirit Swap, whereas Convex is more similar now to Liquid Driver, and it's earning you fees, and they're trying to control the protocol. So yeah, do your own research, but that's the relationship. It has a lot of potential. It really seems that Spirit Swap have got a direction that they want to go, that they want to move in. They have a clear plan, and I like the look of it. So here, that's a Liquid Driver, how you could stake it, lock it away, and earn these rewards. If I go to Liquid Spirit, which is the Lin Spirit, so when I lock away my Lins, when I lock away my Spirit, I receive Lin Spirit, and with that Lin Spirit, I can earn 45% a year. I believe I'm paid in liquid tokens. Yeah, I believe I'm paid in liquid tokens, LQDR, which is cool. The cool thing about Lin Spirit is that you can actually swap your Lin Spirit for Spirit. So if you wanted to get out of this protocol, you're able to do that. You can swap that on Spooky Swap and Spirit Swap, I believe. Your Lin, oh no, it'd be on a Spirit Swap. You can swap your Lin Spirit back to Spirit. Whereas if I just lock it straight up into Spirit, you're unable to like get out. I'm straight up locked in here in jail, a good jail, until 2025. Whereas if I had Lin Spirit, I could then come and like swap back to Spirit if I wanted to. So that's all that for the Spirit and Liquid Driver combo, which you could play with and do some research. Always come down to the docs here. Where would the docs be? Documentation. Just to try and understand, read through and understand. Same with the spirit. Oh, they got docs here at the bottom. Yep, they got docs here. First place you want to go to really understand. So they're my two favourite biggest plays here. Next one is Spooky Swap, which it's another one. It's the biggest farm on, or the biggest decks on Phantom at the moment. The thing I like about this is when you stake your boo, your ex-boo's appreciating 34.7% in a year. So let's say I put in 100 boo tokens, I left it for a year, I'm going to get back 134 boo tokens at the end of the year. Because the ex-boo is becoming more valuable as people are using this swap, and they're earning fees, and then those fees go to the ex-boo token holders, so at a rate of about 35% a year, and that's based on like the volume that's happening. Now, on top of that, then you can stake it into one of these pools, I guess. And so with your ex-boo, then I'd put it into this Wrap Phantom pool here. That's earning me 13.7% a year on top of the 34 with the ex-boo. That's pretty cool. I think at the time when I staked it, I basically knew what Phantom was, so that's why I went here. Maybe now, any other good options? TUSD is good. So that's just a dollar. You're earning 25% there. Another one that I'd like is maybe the LQDR as well, because we've just been through that, haven't we? What that does, so you could basically earn 16%, 17% in LQDR tokens, which is pretty good. And then maybe with that, you want to bring it back into Liquid Driver, then you'd stake your Liquid tokens, lock them away, and then you'd be earning this on them as well. So there's lots of plays here. Check out Spooky Swap. Remember, go to the docs and help to really understand what's going on. This is cool. Another one is Beethoven X. So this is similar to Balancer, where they have some really cool pools over here basically. And what's different, I guess, can I show something maybe like this, the classic trio, Bitcoin, Ethereum and USDC. If I click on here, so rather than having it all done in thirds, you've got 50% in Bitcoin, 30% in Ethereum and 20% in dollars. So this is a kind of good way to have exposure to all three of those tokens. So I mean, half of it being in Bitcoin, that's good, because Bitcoin like rules the whole like crypto space. Ethereum is another strong play in the long term, and then to have some dollars as well, that's going to protect you from the downside risk, but then I guess you won't get as much gains as if you just had it in Bitcoin and Ethereum. You're earning a decent percent. I like that. Is the fees in the last 24 hours. This is what I'm doing. And then you can end up staking your tokens. Then you're earning 30% of the Beethoven's protocol fees, which is also nice. You can play around with this. Again, what am I going to say? Go to the docs just to fully understand what you're doing down here. But this seems pretty good. I don't have loads of money in here. What I do like about this place, though, is that they have some interesting tokens. Come on, let's go. Oh, so yeah, I put some in originally, then I added a bit more tokens, and then I was like, yo, I want to take some tokens out, I need to buy some. And then I've just got my position here with Sol. So this is a place where you can get Solana, Phantom and dollars as well. So I've got them chilling there. I had some Sol from before, so I thought, why not just chuck it in. with some Phantom and some dollars. So that's just earning a percent. I'm going to leave that there long term. I have not much interest in going back to Solana now. So yeah, this is what I'm doing. And look here, I'm earning 38.4%, which is pretty cool. I like that. Beethoven. So the last one is Geist. So this is like Aave, you know, it's a lending and borrowing platform here where you can deposit tokens, receive interest in the native token. So that means if I deposit Bitcoin, I'm going to get 0.18% in Bitcoin over the year, but then I'm going to earn 0.66% in Geist tokens. With those Geist tokens, you can then lock them away, you can vest them or lock them. I will lock them here because they earn platform fees and penalty fees. So this is like when people get liquidated and stuff, or maybe when people unlock their Geist early, that 50% that 50% penalty will go to people like me that are holding the token and that I've locked away. So this is what I earn over a couple of weeks. I don't have loads of money in, but that's a nice way to earn rewards on different tokens. I'm just, you know, that sits in the background. Is it a big play? Well, it's quite speculative at the moment. You can see it's got $1.2 billion. That's how big the market is. So yeah, that's another option. I've definitely spoken for a long time here. I've gone through a good few projects. I would really recommend everybody to do your own research, but I just wanted to open your eyes to these projects. My favorite is Spirit at the moment and how it's working with Liquid Driver. Spooky Swap's cool, but I don't see as much of a direction, a forward plan as Spirit. So I think my longer term play is going to be Spirit. Beethoven's cool if you want to enter some farms and earn some rewards there. And Geist is for borrowing and lending as well. So, but then, I mean, what I like about this compared to Aave is that you're actually part of the protocol and you're earning fees. I'm earning $4.4 a day in platform fees, which is good. So the platform fees is more like all these tokens, the DAI, ETH, Phantom, Curve. That is your platform, whereas the penalty fees, which I'm earning almost $9 a day, that would be in Geist. Now the issue is, I would consider like the DAI, Ethereum, Phantom, and Curve generally more stable than Geist, because it is so they're printing loads of Geist every day, aren't they, as rewards. So I would have more faith, or I trust this number more than I trust that number, because Geist is constantly depreciating in value. Whoa, okay, I'm gonna leave it there. Thank you all for watching my video. Please do your own research. I do have money in all these, but I understand. I understand a bit about what's going on, so that's why I feel comfortable. Don't overexpose yourself to any one platform. That's it. I've been Mo. This is Modify Crypto. Take it easy. Stay safe out there.